angels seek him everywhere. Is he in heaven? Is he in hell? That damned elusive Pimpernel.
Will you not turn to me, my dear, and tell me in what way I may have the honor to serve you?
Percy, can you do aught for Emma?
To do observance to a morn of May? There will I stay for thee.
My good Lysander, I swear to thee, by Cupid's strongest bow, by his best arrow with the golden head, by the simplicity of Venus' doves, by that which knitteth souls and prospers loves, and by that fire which burned the Carthage queen with a false Trojan under sail with thee.
First, good Peter Quince, say what the play treats on. Then read the names of the actors and so grow to a point.
Oh, Mary, our play is the most lamentable comedy and most cruel death of Pyramus and Thisbe.
Oh, a very good piece of work, I assure you. And a Mary. Now, good Peter Quince, call forth your actors by the scroll. Masters, spread yourselves. Oh.
Answer as I call you. Nick Bottom, the weaver.
Ready! Name what part I am for and proceed.
You, Nick Bottom, are set down for Pyramus.
Hey.
Bees blossom, cobweb, moth, and mustard tree.
Ready!
And I.
Demetrius loves her, and he loves not you.
Oh, Helena! Goddess, nymph, perfect, divine, to what, my love, shall I compare thine eye? Crystal is muddy. Oh, how ripened show thy lips, those kissing cherries tempting grow. That pure congealed white high Taurus snow, fanned with an eastern wind, turns to a crow when thou holdst up thy hand. Oh, let me kiss this princess of pure white, this seal of bliss. Oh, swine!
I see you are all fit to set against me for your merriment.
Creon, kinsman, what news have you brought from the gods?
Good news!
I tell you that even troubles hard to bear will end in perfect peace if they find the right issue.
But what is the oracle? So far your words neither frighten nor encourage.
Sir, that you seem to me to have helped in plotting this deed. And indeed, to have done it yourself, short of performing the actual murder with your own hands. And if you had sight, I would say that you did it. In truth, I order you to abide by your own decree, and from this day forth not to speak to these men or to me. You are the accursed defiler of this land.